I mean, it ain't no good.
Amen.
I mean, if you had some cabbage you were going to eat and you had left them on the stove since yesterday. But when you go farther, you find they spoil.
Church,
you have to throw them away.
Amen. I got it.
So the people we read about in the Bible was spoiled. And unless someone opens up the book to them, they cannot see. In St. Matthew chapter 11 and verse 25, let us see what can be found there. St. Matthew, the 11th chapter, and verse 25. St. Matthew, the 11th chapter, verse 25.
At that time, Jesus answered and said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent, and hast revealed them unto babes.
Now, we are told right here, and it becomes so clear and so plain, that the learned people, the sophisticated people, they could not understand the Bible.
No.
Opening up the Bible, that's the subject, my friends. Opening up the Bible. So this verse, St. Matthew 11 and 25, makes us to understand that the Most High had hid these things.
Yes.
You may wonder, well, if the people didn't know him, why didn't they know him? Were they there? Yeah, they were there, but they had been hid. So he said, Shalom. Shalom. How you doing, princess? Shalom. That's all right. Yes. So he's saying that they are hid. Therefore, he was saying that the people would not be able to understand the Bible because the things have been hid from them. And it meant that the only people that would be able to understand the Bible would be those to whom it had been made known to. And when we learn that, then we can know where we stand, where we are going, and how to get to move on with more wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Now in Psalms 83, we will look there and see what we are told. Psalm 83. We will start at verse 2. Psalm 83. We will start at verse 2.
For lo, thine enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head.
Now, he is saying here very clearly, thine enemies make a tumult, plan, prepare, make something to bring you down. Make something, in other words, to trick you, to deceive you, and bring you down. They make a tumult.
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, and what they have made that, they that hate thee, he go on to say, have lifted up the head. Not the people that love you. The people that hate you, you have to keep that in mind. The people that came to the Gold Coast of Africa, kidnapped us, put us on the good slave ship, Jesus. They didn't love us.
No, man.
I know the enemy have made us today most black folk believe that they loved us. But we have to understand, they did not love us.
No.
Not only they don't love us today.
True.
They hate us.
Amen.
And that's what it is saying here.
Yes.
They that hate thee have lifted up their head.
Yeah.
And standing big and tall.
Mm-hmm.
That they can bring you down. Let's go on to verse 3.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
No. You're hearing what it's saying. They, and we go read who is this they.
Yeah.
And we go down further.
Yeah.
We're going to discover who do we talk about.
Yeah.
They have taken crafty counsel. In other words, this ain't something they just laid down and had a dream and said, let's do this and do that. They planned it.
Yes.
They plotted it.
Yes.
They prepared it.
Amen.
It was crafty counsel.
Amen.
That's what they did. Who can you ever imagine could bring a whole nation of people into slavery? And 200 years later, they got those same people believing the man loved them.
Yes.
Believe he loved them.
Never loved
them. It said they have taken
crafty
counsel.
Amen.
That's something, you know. And then you know this was a very well planned thing.
Amen.
You see when they preparing something and planning it, making crafty counsel to get it to go through. I can give you an example. It's like Mr. Bush now tonight over in New York City with their convention. All of that big going on there. And now in this convention, you see they're putting in a few black people.
Yes.
And the one young black girl that's singing, talking about how she is happy for Mr. Bush to be re-elected.
I just switched. I was so mad. But look at that little.
Yeah, one man there, he is the deputy governor in Maryland. Talking that talk. Mr. Bush is the leader we need.
Oh.
Mr. Bush is the man that's going to lead us to safety. You know it? What would you call that? That's crafty counsel.
Yes.
This black man was not a dummy.
No.
He was an educated man.
Yes.
He had degrees.
Yes.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted
against thy hidden ones.
You see, the Most High had us hid from the demon.
Amen.
But we kept wanting to get out.
Yes.
be careful to mix with them, mm-hmm. be like them, become a part of them, but the Most High kept telling us, no, listen.
No.
You be pleased with just me. Don't,
amen.
Don't get involved with those people.
Amen.
Don't want to mingle with them.
No.
You shouldn't want to get married to them.
No.
Well, they do.
Yes.
The Most High told us, and listen, I don't want you getting married. Joining up with nobody except people that's independent.
Amen. Amen.
Well, our people said that they ain't nice people, them brothers and sisters in Israel.
Mm-hmm.
I want to go out there and get me one of them.
Yes. And fear of women.
Yeah. I have them tell me, but look, Rabbi. I'm going to marry him, and I'm going to bring him into, I say, listen, it's not going to work.
No.
Oh, and you should hear such argument. Trying to prove that it is going to work. But you and I can have a little knowledge of the truth tonight. We know it haven't worked yet.
Amen. No. True.
And what they will do, they will take that soul and lead them out the bottom.
Amen.
Take them out.
Yes. True. Amen.
No more keeping Sabbath. Listen. And that soul turns against Israel.
Amen. True.
Start finding all sort of fault with her.
Yes. True.
Don't you know that's crafty counsel?
Amen. Amen.
You have to really see what they're talking about.
Yes.
Crafty counsels.
Mm-hmm.
You see one of them brothers around? I've seen them go up riding on them big motorcycles. Enough jewelry around his neck to open his own jewelry store. Rings on all his fingers and everything. And our little sister get goo-goos about
him. Yes.
They don't mind why they selling a little dope. Yeah, y'all listen what I am saying.
Amen. Amen.
Well, it's crafty counsel.
Yes.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
Yes.
And consulted against thy hidden one.
Amen.
But it's hard for you to believe it, but we're going to try to get you to understand it. The religious world was involved in this confederacy. To make slaves out of God's chosen people.
Amen.
The religious world.
Amen.
Now, I'll agree quickly that the Christians, they were the main leaders.
Yes. Amen.
But they weren't the only one.
No.
You got black folks now say, I don't have nothing to do with Christianity, they made me slave. And they're going getting into Muslims.
Yes.
Not they didn't make you a slave.
Maybe you were slaves.
They have said, come, and let us cut them off from being a nation.
You know, today the hardest thing for you to talk among our people is to talk about trying to build our nation back again.
True. Amen.
No way can you get the interest in it.
True.
They got a million reasons to show you why it cannot work.
Amen.
And the man killed all of that amount of togetherness. Ain't nothing like that in us.
No.
You're saying about togetherness.
Somebody could understand.
We cling strongly to that gospel that says every man for himself. And God for us all. No togetherness, no oneness.
No love, no understanding.
That's gone. That's gone.
Choo-choo. Amen.
They have said, let us cut them off from being a nation. You know it's hard to believe that once upon a time we was a mighty nation. Full of wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. But they did what they had to do to make you a slave.
Amen.
A people that have in their mind about building the nation back again can never be a real slave.
No. Amen.
You don't hear what I'm talking about.
Amen.
Amen.
You gotta get that out of them.
Amen.
Because why? That person is looking back where he come from.
Yes, amen.
You know what I'm looking at. That you. You watch when they come on February every year and they start talking about black history.
Mm-hmm.
They talk about Joe Louis.
Mm-hmm.
Louis Satchmo Armstrong.
Yeah.
Dr. King.
Dr. King.
Not no black history.
Mm-hmm.
What that keep you doing? Looking forward, back, never looking back. To learn that we were the rulers of the universe.
Amen.
We were the kings and the queens.
Amen. Amen.
Great empire.
Amen.
We built the wonders of the world, but they don't tell us that to me. And it's hard for you to convince our people that you did.
True, true. True.
They have come. Let us cut them off from being a nation. That the name of Israel may be no more in their remembrance. Get it completely out of their head.
Yes.
We try to talk to some of our young black brothers and sisters about coming to Israel.
Amen.
Completely out of their head.
True.
You see that young folks coming right out of school, out of high school, going into college, don't know nothing about themselves.
True. Amen.
Don't know nothing about their religion.
Amen.
No more in their remembrance. They won't remember it no more. Now the only way they're going to remember it again, somebody got to open up the Bible.
Amen.
And that's the subject, isn't it?
Amen.
Open up the Bible.
Amen.
So if don't nobody open up the Bible, how would they ever know? What we are reading here is a complete history about us.
Amen.
But somebody just pick up the Bible and read it, don't they? What is it? They ain't saying nothing. They have cut them off from being a nation. The black folks would never understand if that's talking about them. That our enemies, the Christians, the Muslims, cut us off.
Amen.
For they have consulted together with one consent.
Are you listening to this?
Amen.
In this great conflict, they consulted together with one consent.
Amen.
They are confederate against us.
Amen.
Are you seeing what it is saying, saints?
Amen. Amen.
Now, when we get to verse 6, it begins to tell us about they. It will tell you what they have did. They have taken counsel against you. They have did this, they have this, they did they. Who is they? Well, when they get to verse 6, it starts naming them all.
Yes, amen.
Let us read.
The tabernacles of Edom.
Listen, number one. Who are the they? Number one, the churches of Edom. That's the Edomites. Y'all see it there? He says the tabernacle, that means it's the church where they go.
Amen.
Of Edom.
And the Ishmaelites.
I don't think I need to tell y'all who are the Ishmaelites. Everybody in this building knows talking about Islam.
Amen.
Can y'all say
amen
here?
Amen.
Now what you got here? You got the counterfeit Jews. You got the Muslims.
Amen.
Who are they? That's what we're learning here. Yes?
Of Moab and the Hagarines.
Well. Verse 7.
Jebus.
Yes.
And Ammon.
Oh, goodness.
And Amalek. The Philistines with the inhabitants of Tyre.
Verse 8.
Assur also is joined with them.
Listen, if you please.
Amen.
Nobody was left out, saints.
Amen.
They all was in confederate against us.
Amen.
Amen.
And that's what the word is telling us here. We've got to have somebody to open up the Bible, as we are doing here tonight in the class. Somebody got to set the time and open it up.
Amen.
Let you understand what he's talking about.
Amen.
It's dealing about when we were brought from the motherland.
Yes.
Brought here to North and South America.
Amen.
The West Indies. Amen. Latin America. Central America.
Yes, that's true.
Folks is asking the Most High to do unto them like they have teardrops, you know. Get even. What does verse 9 say?
Do unto them.
Yes.
As unto the
Midianites. Yes.
As the Seirah.
Yeah.
As the Jabin.
Oh my.
At the brook of Kishon. Which perished at
They became a dung for the earth. Make thou no bow, not body, and not dead. Yea, all the princes, Azia, and Azaria, who said, let us take to ourselves the houses of God in possession. Let us completely take over our religion.
Yes.
They did.
Amen.
I said they did.
Amen.
I don't care how you meet a young man tonight and he just fresh out of college, got his papers. He don't know nothing about what we're talking about here.
Amen.
I met a young black boy that was so bright, had so much knowledge. They could tell me the name of Churchill's dog. I didn't know it, but they did. They know the name of Mr. Churchill's dog. They knew the name of the cigars he smoked. They didn't know nothing about this here that I'm showing you.
Amen.
They didn't know nothing about it.
Right.
They said, we want to take over their houses, their God. We want to take over their religion. Strip it up. They take your name away from you.
Yes.
Some of us can't remember the movie Roots.
Mm-hmm.
You see how they beat the dog out of that church and decide who he was. Verse 13.
Oh my God.
Yes.
Make them like a wheel.
Yes.
As the stubble before the wind.
Just mention. Verse 14.
As the fire burneth the wood, and as the flame setteth the mountains on fire.
Okay.
So persecute them with
thy temper. Listen at the request. Listen at the request. It's a said to the Almighty, please persecute me. Yes.
And make them afraid with thy song.
Put fear in them.
Amen.
Like they had it in us.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Amen. We used to be fighting to go outdoors at night. They taught us all them Book of Bear stories, you remember? So many black folks, even tonight, leave in the darkest Book of Bear out there waiting on them. Educated black folks fighting to go by cemetery.
Amen.
Don't want to go by no graveyard.
Yes.
Y'all listen, what I said, when listen to request, it's look, put the fear in them.
Amen.
Give them something to fear.
Yes.
They made extra everything.
They have denied the Lord.
Now listen. They have lied on the Lord. They have lied about the Lord. So they have denied him. They have denied the Lord. Yes.
And said. It is not he.
Do y'all hear what I'm telling you? Do you see it in the Bible? In Isaiah 52 and 6, he said, but in that day they don't know. In that day, they don't know. I'm going to give them all one language. Yeah, I hear people telling me, I've talked to some folks sometimes, House of Israel, and said, who are you? That's my rabbi. Do you speak Hebrew? I said, no, I don't. How you going to be a rabbi? Then you don't even speak Hebrew. I said, you speak Hebrew? Yeah. I said, then where did you learn? Who taught it to you? He said, I got it from the people overseas. I said, let me tell you, they don't know it.
They don't know it.
They don't know it themselves.
Amen.
Zephaniah 3 and 9, look what they're told. In Zephaniah 3 and 9,
For then will I turn to the people a pure language.
Listen. You just need somebody to open the Bible. Got some kind of language. It's babbling all over again, a state of confusion. But you keep in mind in Isaiah 52 and 6, he told us, my people don't know my name.
Amen.
And the house of Israel will know.
Amen.
Now, look what we are told here in Zephaniah. Let me hear it again.
For then will I turn to the people in pure language.
Do y'all have that? 3 and 9. He got to give the people a pure language. They don't have it today. They don't have it today. The house of Israel is going to receive it.
Amen.
The house of Israel is going to receive it in a pure language.
Amen.
All of us will talk with one language.
Yes, amen.
When we can start talking one language, look in Zechariah 14 and 9. Zechariah 14.
And the Lord shall be king over all the earth.
When we start speaking in one language, the house of Israel going to recognize that.
Amen.
We ain't talking about a king that's the king of South 7th Street.
Amen.
All the earth.
He's king of South 7th Street. 33 blocks on South 7th Street. But what did it say?
All the earth.
In that day,
the Lord shall be king over all the earth.
Oh, can you believe it?
Amen.
Will you receive it?
Amen.
Lord, who have believed on the Lord?
Yes.
Read on. What else did it say?
In that day shall there be one Lord.
Listen now, listen now. In that day it will be with one Lord.
One Lord.
Yes.
And his name one.
It ain't going to have but just one name.
Amen.
Amen. That time is going to change. I wish they had a little longer. That's it. If you have questions, comments, or remarks, we will take them. Yes, princess.
Let us say it.
Yeah. You don't have time to play. Thank you so very, very much. And if there is no questions, comments, or remarks, this service can come to a close. Let us stand. Anthem.
I am historical.
I am poetic.
rest of me is filled with good news.
The rest of me is filled with good news.
What am I?
What about the Bible?
The Bible. Okay? How many books are there in the Bible?
There are 66 books in the Bible.
Right, they are?
66 books in the Bible.
How many books are there in the New Testament?
There are 27 books in the New Testament.
And how many books are there in the Old Testament?
There are 39 books in the Old Testament.
Gives us a total of
66 books in the
entire Bible. Okay, let's say the books of the Bible now.
The books of the Bible are Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1 and 2 Samuel, 1 and 2 Kings, 1 and 2 Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Songs of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Michael, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Abihail, Zechariah, Malachi. John, Acts of the Apostle, Roman, 1st and 2nd Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1st and 2nd Thessalonians, 1st and 2nd Timothy, Titus, Philemon, Hebrews, James, 1st, 2nd Peter, 1st, 2nd and 3rd John, Jude, Revelation.
So there are 66 books in the Bible. Let's say the months of the Jewish year for us.
The months of the Jewish year are Abib, Sif, Sivan, Tammuz, Av, Elu, Etanem, Mud, Shishlu, Tibet, Sivat, Yedar. Yedar is the last month.
Start. A is for Alpha.
A is for Alpha. B is for Red Light. C is for Consular. D is for Liberal. E is for Emmanuel. F is for First. G is for Godhead. H is for Ottoman. I is for I am. J is for Judge of Israel. K is for King of Kings. L is for Lawgiver. M is for Monastar. N is for Nazarene. O is for Omnipotent.
P is for Prince of Peace.
R is for Rose of Aaron, S is for Shiloh, T is for Tree of Life, U is for Unspeakable Gift, V is for Vine, W is for Wall of Fire, X is for Exodus, the second book in the Bible, Y is for Yoke, Z is for Zion, the place where the Lord resides to dwell.
How many tribes of Israel are there?
There are 12 tribes of Israel.
There are
12 tribes of Israel.
Name them.
The 12 tribes of Israel are Reuben, Simon, Levi, Judah, Dan, Naphtali, Gad, Asher, Issachar, Zebulun, Joseph, and Benjamin.
Okay, I'm going to ask you some questions, but this week we're doing revision. How many tribes of Israel are there?
12 tribes of Israel.
How many tribes?
12 tribes of Israel.
Right, name them for me.
The 12 tribes of Israel are Reuben, Simon, Levi, Judah, Dan, Naphtali, Gad, Asher, Issachar, Zebulun, Joseph, and Benjamin.
Right. And how many tribes are there in Guyana presently?
Four tribes in Guyana.
Name the four tribes.
The four tribes in Guyana are Simon,
tribes.
Yeah, and then the four tribes of Caribbean.
The Caribbean. And the rest of the world.
Yes, please.
How many gospel writers are there?
There are four gospel writers.
How many?
Four gospel writers.
Name them.
Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
Matthew, Mark,
Luke, and John.
And we said, we mentioned earlier that Job is the oldest book
in the Bible.
And can you tell me what is the oldest doctrine? What is the oldest doctrine?
The oldest doctrine
is?
Was written, the oldest doctrine in the Jewish writing is that Elijah shall come and restore our things.
Okay, anybody say that? The oldest doctrine in Jewish writing
is Elijah shall first come and restore all things.
Right, he shall first come
and restore all things.
We have some words and meaning. The first word is potentate. What's the meaning of the word potentate? What it means, Amilo?
Potentate means a king who has great power and who can do anything he likes.
Okay, everybody say it. Potentate
means a king or god
who has great power and can do anything he likes. That is the meaning of the word potentate. And we were saying, we were teaching the world that the Lord Elijah, he is the only potentate. He's what?
The only potentate.
Right, there's nobody else that can fit that description. What's the meaning of the word omnipotent?
The meaning of the word omnipotent is Elijah is all powerful.
Elijah is all
powerful.
Right. He's the only potentate person and he is omnipotent. What's the meaning of that word again?
Elijah is all powerful.
Right. What's the meaning of the word omnipresent?
Omnipresent. Elijah is always present.
Elijah is
always present.
Right. And when we say that Elijah is always present, what we say? What we mean by that?
He is always around.
Right, he is always around. Even if you cannot see him, he's right there.
Yes.
When you go to school, he's there. When you're at home, he's there. When you go out on the road, he's there. Everywhere you go, he is right there. Right? He is watching over all of us and he's protecting us. Okay?
Yes.
So when you see you go to school, you have to be on your best behavior. Okay? You don't behave nice and all good in church. And when you go to school, you're a different person when you're in school. You have to maintain that same good behavior. Okay? Yes. Because the Lord Elijah is always
watching.
He is always
watching. Present.
He is always seeing and he is always present.
And he is always
seeing. Even if you can't see him, he is there watching you to see what you're doing and to see how you're behaving in school. And when you go to the sea wall and when you go to parties, he's watching at everything you do. Right? So you must glorify him by being on here.
Best behavior.
So you must always remember that Elijah is always
present.
He is always
present.
Even after the Sabbath school that we have right now, he's right here watching you. So you need to be on your best behavior when you're in service, when you're in church. You must not be walking up and down, talking, eating, drinking water, and doing your own thing in church, because he's right there on his throne and he's looking at you. Okay? Yes. Always remember that. So omnipresent is Elijah is always present. Omnipresent is Elijah is always present. What is the meaning of the word omniscient?
Elijah is always seeing.
Elijah is
always seeing.
He's always seeing. So he's always present. And he's always seeing. You need to listen to the sermons. What do you need to do?
Listen to the sermons.
Right. That's the only way you can be good children. A good listener is a good
learner.
A good listener is a good
learner.
Right. So when you're in church, you need to listen to the message. Because our Lord Elijah is on his throne and he is seeing everything that you are doing. Okay?
Yes.
Good. So we understand, we not even know the meaning of the word, but we understand what it says. Right? Let's go on to another question. What are the two greatest commandments? What are the two greatest commandments?
The
two greatest commandments
is, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one.
Right. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. Okay, or one God. Right? Let's say it.
Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord.
Or one God. Okay, and the next one is?
Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
Right. Thou shalt
love thy neighbors as thyself.
So those two commandments are the two greatest commandments. Right? Yes. You must love your neighbors
as yourself.
Not more than yourself or less than yourself. Okay?
Yes.
Good. You love your neighbor as yourself. Just go, you love yourself. You love your friend, your brother, your sister, your cousin, the elders in Israel. You love them too. The kings, the queens, and so even unto the sick, even unto a small child, a child that is smaller than you, you love that child as if you were loving yourself. So you love your neighbor as yourself. Right? Not more than yourself. You're not giving away and leaving yourself without. Okay?
Yes.
You share equally. Right, so the commandment is saying, thou shalt love
thy neighbor
as thyself. That is what is one of the commandments is saying, thou shalt love thy neighbor
as thyself.
And the next one is hear, O Israel.
The Lord our God is one Lord.
Well, as we know, we don't teach the doctrine of Holy Trinity. You all know what is Holy Trinity?
No.
When you serve in many gods, three gods come together, agreeing in one. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. Right? We don't preach that doctrine. We don't have that doctrine as existing in our religion. So, Ariel as well, the Lord our God is one Lord. Only one God we serve. One true and living God. Right?
Yes,
so
yes.
We worship and we serve
one
true and living God. And what is his name?
The Lord Elijah.
The Lord Elijah. Right, so the commandment is saying, Hear, O Israel.
The Lord our God is one.
Right. So don't have any other. His name is the Lord Elijah. Right? So those two commandments are the two greatest commandments of all. Okay?
Yes.
And once you could keep these two commandments, all the rest of commandments, all the other commandments, you can be able to keep those commandments too. Right?
Yes.
O Lord Elijah, incline thine ear and hear. Open thy eyes and behold our desolation, and the city which is called by thy name. For we do not present our supplication before thee for our righteousnesses, but for thy great mercies. O Lord Elijah, hear. O Lord Elijah, forgive. O Lord Elijah, hearken and do. Therefore not for thy own sake, O my God Elijah, for thy city and thy people are called by thy name. Amen.
Don't give your love to all the gods.
Yeah.